pledge. Well, I'm sorry all to hell. I screwed up. I can't go back and change things now. Look, when your father left me, I was your age. I didn't even know how to make a brownie. I only knew how to be me. I am Arlene McKenzie. I am what I am. I am your crazy, off-the-wall mother who loves you. And that is the bottom line. And if you don't like it, you can go to your room. I'm not a well person.
Oh, isn't this great? We're yelling at each other for the first time.
Heck, if I knew yelling made you this happy, I would have screamed just silly years ago.
Well, it was worth the wait.
Look, honey, you're just a kid. And tomorrow morning you're gonna wake up and wonder what happened to the last 20 years of your life. And it's scary. And if you're alone, it's even more scary. That's why every once in a while I do something crazy, like a Ramon or a Rachmaninoff or even kissing David. Do you understand?
Yes. I guess mothers are women too.
I guess. Baby.
David? Are you sure you didn't enjoy that kiss? Maybe even just a little teensy bit.
I swear, Claudia, I felt zero, zip, zilch. It's like kissing my aunt. Of course, my aunt happens to be Miss Florida. I'm only kidding, Miss Texas.
Are you two okay?
We're great.
You know, Arlene, that offer to stay is still open.
I'd love to, after I come back.
Back from where?
Paris. You see, tonight, after I made a fool of myself with David, I sort of looked up an old friend I used to go out with in college. And he's sort of recently divorced, and sort of president of a bank, and sort of leaving tomorrow for Paris, and he sort of asked me to join him.
Paris. Oh, that's so romantic.
Ooh.
I'd give anything to go to France.
The best I can do is make you some French toast.
Even better.
Mom, you sure you want to go to Europe with this guy?
I don't know, honey. Why?
Well, I thought that since we just started to really talk, maybe you'd like to stick around for a couple days.
Oh, I'd love to. On the other hand...
We'll talk when you get back.
What came in today?
More guard dogs that moo?
No, I called those bozos and I really read them the riot act. They sent me these replacements. I'm gonna be a zillionaire.
You know, Jay, I gotta tell you, those guard dogs aren't all they're quacked up to be.
Guys, I just got a letter from my mother. She joined the boat people.
She's in Vietnam?
No, Dennis. She married a gondolier.
Next year's winner of 5 Emmys, Diane's giving acting lessons to an ex-robber. Will he end up stealing more than the show? Then catch the Emmy-winning Hill Street Blues. Will reckless gambling cost Officer Hill his $100,000? Sunday night, it's a superstar reunion. The Emmy-winning musical special, Motown 25. Be there.
Ladies, my new $1 million seller.
An executive pea shooter? An umbrella?
It may look like a mere umbrella, but get a load of this. The personalized musical umbrella.
That's great, Jay.
Whatever your name is, I find the song and stick it in this umbrella. It can be any name there's a song for. Mary, Margie, Peggy Sue, Goldfinger. What's your name?
It's Beth.
Okay, what's your middle name?
Myrna.
So there are one or two names I can't do. Give me another name. Come on.
Ralph.
Ralph. My life is a giant cow pie.
Yes, I'm collecting money for unwed giraffes.
Oh, it's beautiful.
Where'd you get it?
David won him for me at the church bazaar. He dunked a nun 4 times.
He sat on my lap in the limousine. We stuck his neck through the sunroof.
Wow, where'd you get a limo?
Oh, Claudia's Uncle Victor drove us.
Uncle Victor! Well, I certainly see the family resemblance. He's gorgeous.
You're making me blush. Oh,
this is my Uncle Victor. Victor, this is Jay.
Hi, Jay.
How do you do?
Beth.
Hi.
Hi, Beth.
This is Mickey.
Hi, Mickey.
Hi, nice to meet you. Come, sit down.
Must be great having an uncle who's a chauffeur.
Jay, it's Victor's limousine. He owns it.
I'm just filling in. You see, my chauffeur has been acting a little strange lately. Last week, he took the subway to Brooklyn.
So?
He wouldn't give it back.
Excuse me. But did anyone ever tell you you have an accent?
Just Charro.
But Claudia doesn't have an accent.
Well, he's not really my uncle.
I'm just an old friend of the family.
Wait a minute. You're famous, aren't you? You were on the cover of Big Business magazine last year.
Only twice.
Of course. You're Victor Sandoval, Sandoval International. Jay Bostwick, Bostwick International. Hey, want to get in on the ground floor of the musical umbrella industry?
See, Jay imports these umbrellas that sing songs about your name, but only if you've got a name that somebody already wrote a song about. If not, it's just a regular singing umbrella that sings songs about somebody else's name. Unless, of course, you want to change your name.
I understood that perfectly, which worries me. I've got a thought. If you don't mind suggestions.
Hey, Vic, you scratch my back, I'll scratch yours.
Instead of all the names, why don't you have it play Singing in the Rain?
Singing in the Rain, what a great idea! Have you ever considered merging with a smaller firm? Say, one with curly hair?
I might be interested in distributing them.
Really? It's a tantalizing proposition. Of course, I'll have to wait for my next board of directors meeting. All in favor? Aye.
Well, I won't call you up. You'll be late for the football game.
No, that's okay. Would you like to come with us?
We could get another ticket.
Oh, no, thank you. I think I'll pass.
Well, guys, we don't want to be late for the kickoff.
Beth coaches a nursery school team.
Hey, how's the team doing?
Well, we got some problems. It's hard running when you're tripping over your diapers.
Say, good night. See okay. You later.
See you.
Bye-bye.
Bye now.
See you later, pard.
Could I get you anything?
No, it's not necessary.
It's my job. I'm the maid.
Oh, really? Well, how would the maid like to have lunch with a chauffeur?
Well, there are a few things I should do.
Like what?
Well, Sundays I usually shovel out Jay's bedroom.
Oh. It's a pity because I had made reservations to a wonderful French restaurant. They make magnificent Chateaubriand, but only for two.
Gosh, I wouldn't want you to go hungry.
You will be crazy about Maxine's.
Maxine? I don't think I know that restaurant. Where is it? On the east side?
No.
The west side?
No, on the right bank.
Oh, Jersey.
No, in Paris.
Paris?
Where is she?
Dave. She told the doorman she was going to lunch with Victor.
All right, Jay. What we're going to have to do here is call every French restaurant in this city and ask if they've seen Mickey and Victor.
How are you going to describe Mickey without using your hands? Besides, there must be 100 French restaurants in Manhattan. We can't call all of them.
Yeah, you're right. We're going to have to go in person. You take the ones that start with Petite, I'll take the ones that start with Shea.
Dave. Let's just hit the sack.
Who can sleep at 2 o'clock in the morning?
You're getting a little crazy. Mickey's gonna be fine. A, she's a grown-up. B, she's a very responsible person. C, Victor is Claudia's uncle, and he's a gentleman.
I'm shocked.
Why?
That made sense.
Hey, I'm not just another pretty face.
You're right. Come on, let's hit the sack.
Oh, Victor, this was the nicest day of my life. I loved Paris. Thank you for Maxine. Thank you for my outfit. And I always wanted to fly on the Concorde.
I had a wonderful time myself.
It was great the way you battered that eclair right through the Arc de Triomphe.
Merci.
Oh, and imagine being waited on by the owner of the restaurant.
Oh, Jacques is a dear old friend.
He wouldn't even let you pay.
Oh, you probably don't remember. But a long time ago, it was a thing called World War II. When we invaded Normandy, I parachuted behind enemy lines and kind of saved his town. Jack was very grateful. In fact, he made me his son's godfather. And his son has a daughter now about your age. Well, I better be going now.
Oh, what a crazy night. We actually danced in a fountain. It was lucky the violinist could swim.
You looked beautiful in the moonlight.
Everything looked beautiful in the moonlight.
You really liked Paris, didn't you?
Uh-huh. Only there's just one thing.
What's that?
Frenchmen really do pinch a lot. I got pinched every block.
Well, I have a little confession to make.
That was you?
I'm sorry.
I'm not.
Good night.
Good night, Victor.
I'm glad you had a good time.
I did.
Good.
Thanks.
It was my pleasure.
Good night. I live here.
Right. Well, I guess it's my turn now.
I guess.
Mickey, before I go, may I ask you one little thing?
Sure.
Will you marry me?
Mickey, you said what?
I said yes.
You mean you said yes, you didn't want to marry him?
No, I said yes. Yes, I did want to marry him.
Nick, we're out of mayonnaise. Waffles aren't the same without mayo.
Mickey's getting married.
I'll just have to go with mustard.
You know, I knew your uncle couldn't be trusted.
Well, it's not his fault he met a beautiful girl.
Look, Claudia, I meet beautiful girls all the time, but do I marry them?
What do you do with them?
That's terrific. Great news. That's marvelous.
What?
I'm gonna marry Victor.
I think it's wonderful. I hope you'll be very happy.
Thanks.
Listen, Mick, are you sure about this? I mean, let's weigh the pros and the cons here, all right? The pluses and the minuses. Now, one, Victor's old enough to be your father.
Two, you hardly know him.
What kind of life will you have? Jetting all over the world, living in the finest hotels, eating in the best restaurants, people waiting on you hand and foot.
If you don't marry him, I will.
Oh, wow. You're gonna be my Aunt Mickey.
Look, no matter what you put on your side of the page, my side of the page is longer.
For example?
For example, I love Victor.
Mick, see, that's not being rational.
Oh, David, men are always accusing women of not being rational, acting with their hearts and not their brains. Now, and I have to bite my tongue to get these words out of my mouth. Men basically run everything, right?
Well, they're...
So, if men are so rational, how come the world is so screwed up? If you love him, you marry him. And the hell with what any man thinks.
Right on. Go for it.
Listen, Mick, I want you to be just as happy as these two,
but... Oh, I knew you would. Jay?
Oh, I hope you two are very happy.
Oh, thanks.
But I'd sure like to know more about this guy.
Like what?
Like, can he really help me unload my umbrellas?
See, I think Victor's too good to be true. If he can fall for Mickey in 2 seconds, maybe he can fall for someone else just as quickly.
Yeah.
You see that girl down at the end of the bar? She's gonna come on to Victor.
Are you sure?
Uh-huh.
How do you know?
Trust me.
Wow, what a gift.
Call it ESP, call it intuition, call it paying an out-of-work actress $20. Okay, battle stations.
Jay?
Hi, Victor.
David? Thanks for inviting me to join you.
Our pleasure. Have a seat.
Yeah. Thank you. Hey, nice place.
Yeah, mostly people from the neighborhood. Some professionals, some blue collars.
Some out-of-work actresses.
I'm supposed to have something old, something new, something borrowed, and something blue.
What's the old?
This was Grandma Mackenzie's.
A lace garter. Isn't that nice?
Actually, it's a turn-of-the-century sweatband.
What about the new?
I have the same thing.
Well, let's see. I would be very, very happy if you would wear this.
Oh, Claudia, it's beautiful.
It was given to me on a very romantic evening. I hope it brings you as much romance as it did me.
Won't David mind?
Who said it was from David?
Thanks. What about blue? I have nothing blue.
Just look under Jay's pillow. You can borrow his Smurf.
Thank you.
See, it's just that we have grave concerns.
I, for one, am not going to give my blessing until I know what your intentions are.
My intention is to marry Mickey and live happily ever after.
What kind of a cock and bull plan is that?
Oh, wow. You're Victor Sandoval. I loved your interview in Rolling Stone. Brahms versus Bowie, one man's opinion.
What can I say?
I'd love to sit and rap with you if you'd like to. You know, really.
Well, Bunny, I will
Bunny,
like...
you know my name.
You were electrifying in Doomsday at the Diner. Off Broadway.
Actually, it was in Staten Island, and I only had one line.
Oh, she did with it. I mean, any other actors would have said, more coffee, sir? Or more coffee, sir? Or even more coffee, sir? But you gave every word a life of its own. More coffee, sir? Awesome. Bunny, thank you for providing me with an evening of gratifying, thought-provoking entertainment. Thank you for being you.
And you said he was a sleazeball.
When I was a little girl, I always thought I'd fall in love with someone that had Robert Redford's dimples and Arnold Schwarzenegger's body and Al Pacino's smoldering eyes. And guess what? I did.
You are in love. If David asked me to marry him, I'd have to stall him till I got my purse.
Why?
That's where I keep my wedding dress. The minister and the flower girls are in the trunk of my car.
I'm never going to get married.
Why not?
Because it's impossible to be happier than I am right now.
Listen, I respect what you are doing. You obviously feel very close to Mickey, and you don't want it to get hurt.
That's right.
So there's no way I can convince you that I'm the perfect man for her, right? So I want to leave the decision up to you. If you say yes, I'll be the happiest man in town. If you say no, well, you decide.
Go ahead, Dave.
No, you go first. B for Bostwick before T for Tucker.
D for David before J for Jay.
You're taller.
You're older.
What was the name of Gene Autry's horse?
Dale Evans.
You know, this is stupid. What are we doing meddling in someone else's life?
Yeah. Right.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Be happy.
Thank you.
What would you have done if we said no?
Well, like we all like to say in a situation like this, no importa donde te escondas o cómo te escondas o cuánto tiempo te escondas, tarde o temprano te encontraré y me vengaré.
Can't argue with that.
Talk to you.
Oh, I don't think that's right. Grandma McKenzie used to say, see the groom before the day, all the love will float away. See the bride before the time, Someone sure to spill the wine. Little Grandma Mackenzie is to talk to her mixmaster.
Mickey.
Victor? Victor?
Mickey. I had a drink with Jay and David tonight. There were a lot of people in the place. Younger couples, older couples. But there were no younger, older couples.
Have you been talking to your mixmaster?
I'm old enough to be your father.
You're young enough to be my husband.
It will be a mistake.
Falling in love and wanting to spend the rest of your life with someone is a mistake?
Look the way everybody reacted when we told them the news. Jay and David are your best friends, right?
Yes.
And they could hardly accept it.
Okay, that's it, Victor Sandy Man.
Sandoval.
Close enough. Look, you told me all your life you've done what you wanted to do. You marched to your own drummer. So why all of a sudden do you give a rat's pat to what other people think? No, Victor.
Let me explain to you.
Too late, Victor. You got me whether you like it or not. And if you don't show up on that altar tomorrow, the wedding's off. The wedding's off? Oh.
I love you.
I love you.
You got the ring?
Yeah.
Oh, right.
Nervous?
No, no. You got the ring?
Yeah.
How do I look?
Great. I got the ring.
Just nerves.
Right. Will you carry me?
We are gathered here in the presence of these witnesses for the purpose of uniting in matrimony Victor Sandoval and Mickey Mackenzie. Marriage is not only a happy occasion, but a solemn one as well, and should not be entered into lightly, but thoughtfully and seriously, and with a deep realization of its obligations and responsibilities. Who gives this woman in matrimony?
I do.
Victor, do you take this woman, Mickey, to be your lawful wedded wife?
I do.
Do you, Mickey, take this man, Victor, to be your lawful wedded husband?
Break Sam's heart when her ex-lover returns? Cheers! Next! Then it's Cop Against Cop when Rico confronts Bobby on Hill Street Blues tonight. And Sunday, don't miss Princess Daisy. Judith Krantz's blockbuster bestseller explodes on TV in an unforgettable miniseries. Princess Daisy, Sunday on NBC. Be there.
Victor.
He's gorgeous.
You're making me blush.
Of course. You're Victor Sandoval. Sandoval International. Jay Bostwick. Bostwick International. Hey, how would you like to get in on the ground floor of the musical umbrella industry?
I'm the maid.
Oh, really? How will the maid like to go for lunch with a chauffeur? May I ask you one little thing?
Sure.
Will you marry me?
Am I doing the wrong thing? Do I want to get married? Who am I? Where am I?
Victor, do you take this woman, Mickey, to be your lawful wedded wife?
I do.
Mickey, do you take this man, Victor, to be your lawful wedded husband?
I do. Oh.
The ring.
The ring.
The ring.
The ring. Oh, the ring. Oh. Here, hold this, would you?
Okay.
I know I put it someplace safe. Oh. Bostwick, you ninny. Who'd put a ring on a finger?
By virtue of the authority vested in me by the state of New York, I now pronounce you husband and wife. You may kiss the bride.
Nah, he should get the first shot. The honor of the next dance with your bride, sir?
Certainly, Jay.
I know you just got married and everything, but would it be okay if I still loved you?
Of course.
I've been dancing all my life. My mother used to dance around the room for hours with me standing on her feet.
I know how she felt.
Oh, sorry.
May I cut in?
Sure. But Dave, she's a little fussy. She won't let you stand on her feet.
Thanks for giving me away.
My pleasure, Mrs. Sandoval. Never seen anyone look more beautiful or happier. I'm gonna miss you.
Thanks.
Vic, you know, it's times like this that make you reevaluate your life. Confront what's truly meaningful. Like, where is it written that batteries have to power one's musical umbrella?
What do you say? Should we do it? We've got the minister, we've got the organist, the food, the flowers, everything we need.
Your parents aren't here.
We'll send them a picture.
What? A call from the president? Be right there.
Don't you love me?
Well, it's not that I don't love you. It's just that I...
Look.
Just that I...
If you don't want to marry me, then just say it.
All right. Let's get married.
Just like that? What, are you crazy?
aren't even here.
Okay, maybe it's not umbrellas. How about musical galoshes? Okay, talking dentures? Inflatable food. Victor, yoo-hoo. Oh, Victor, please, you just got married. You're embarrassing both of us. Oh, boy.
So romantic, the splendor of the wedding night. First, Victor will kiss you on your fawn-like earlobes. Mm-hmm. Yeah, and then he'll whisper,
I love you, my darling. When I touch you, your skin has the feel of rich Corinthian leather.
Dave, I gotta tell you this joke. Dave, we got a little problem. What is it? Victor, he's gone.
Don't be silly, he's right over there.
I mean, gone. G-O-N-E.
You mean G-O-N-E? As in D-E-A-D?
What happened? He died.
I know that. What are we gonna do?
I got it.
Sunglasses? Jay, glare is not Victor's problem.
Don't kill it, Mickey, no.
It's her wedding night. I think she's gonna find out.
All right, how do we break the news?
We just can't stand up and announce it.
Yeah, nothing can slow down a wedding like a dead groom. I know. I'll get Beth. She'll know what to do. She was in the Navy. Jake! Links are hooked.
Say, how about a couple of candid shots of you two guys and the groom?
Sure.
Okay.
Great.
Hey, how about a toast?
How you doing?
I'm okay. Kinda. I want you to know that without you and Jay, I wouldn't have made it through this last month. Thanks. I have coffee, tea, muffins, and sweet rolls. See, I've never been to a reading of a will before. I don't know what you serve.
Mick, it's very simple. The lawyer will come in, he'll read a very formal document. Before you know it, it'll all be over.
Oh, so it's not like on Dallas or anything?
No.
Do I look okay?
Sure. Who are you?
You look very nice, Jay.
Well, I wanted to look my best, so I borrowed a couple of things from Dave.
Like what?
Shoes, socks, underwear, shirt, tie.
Jay, you'll never change. I hope. Oh, gosh, that's the lawyer. Hi.
Hi, Mom.
What?
I'm your son.
Who are you kidding, fella? You don't even have the same color hair.
I'm Philip Sandoval. Victor was my father.
Oh, come on in. Oh, I would have known you were Victor's son anyway. You have his forehead.
Only there's more of it.
say?
David Tucker, my father spoke very highly of you. He had great respect for your opinions, your intelligence, your integrity. And you must be the one with the musical umbrellas.
Right. He had a great respect for those two.
I feel like I know you all so well. But especially you. I wish I could have seen you and my father in Paris playing hide-and-seek in the Louvre.
He told you about that? Uh-huh. He took my picture next to the Mona Lisa.
I know. He said, compared to you, she looked like a dog.
Okay, let's go to the kitchen.
Why?
I need your advice. I'm going to wallpaper the freezer.
Oh, right. How about a nice bold print? Or a pastoral scene, something with cows and a butter churn.
I'm sorry I couldn't make it to your wedding, but I was in Melbourne closing a big deal in didgeridoos.
Didgeridoo what?
Didgeridoos. They're those wonderful musical instruments the Aborigines play. Kind of sounds like...
I like that.
It was my own idea, and Dad said, go for it.
I'm sure he'd be proud of the way you'll run the company.
I just hope I do a good job. Victor Sandoval is a hard act to follow. He was very special.
Yeah. Excuse me.
Hi, Mickey.
Hi.
This is Richard Hodges, Victor's attorney.
My condolences on your bereavement.
Thank you.
Well, let's get this show on the road. Now, if everyone will just gather around here and fill up. Now, this is all boilerplate. It really just doesn't amount to much. We charge a fortune for it, but it really doesn't matter. Here we are. Now, this is important stuff. To my son, Philip, I leave 10,000 shares of stock in Sandoval International. And to my wife, Mickey Mackenzie Sandoval, the remaining 10,001 shares, which represents controlling interest in the company. Congratulations, you are now the president of Sandoval International.
Way to go, Mom.
You know, I just discovered something.
What's that?
You leave dirty dishes sitting around a kitchen for a week or so, and eggs turn into yellow cement. This place looks like it did before we hired Mickey. We've got to clean it up.
Can we afford a bulldozer?
How's it going, guys?
You know, if you look in Jay's bathtub, you can see the beginnings of the evolution of life. You guys better have a little talk with Mickey.
We don't see her that often. She's in her office by 7:30 every morning. She doesn't get home here till late.
I'd feel like a rat making her work for us after she's put in a 12-hour day.
A rat? Well, you'd fit right in with all this garbage.
Well, I'll clean tonight, but I'm not going to do it for the rest of my life. This is woman's work. Why does the word capon suddenly come to mind? Hi, Mick.
Hi. Sorry I'm so late. You guys must be starved.
Oh, that's okay. We'll get some Chinese food. Unless there's some already under the couch.
No, I'll get something cooking.
You got your choice. Either maraschino cherries or baking soda.
Okay, that's one from column A and two from column B for five.
Guys, can I ask you something? I've been looking over the books, and I think the company's in trouble.
Boy, there's a lot of red ink in these books.
Yeah, it looks like somebody had a nosebleed on them.
I thought Victor was so successful.
Oh, he
it was.
Sounds like he ran the business on his personality.
Well, he certainly didn't run it on capital. I think you're going to have to cut back.
Well, I packed my own lunch, and I used my tea bag twice.
No, he means you're going to have to cut back on staff.
You know, Mick, it looks like you're going to lose $20,000, $30,000 this year. That's just about what you're paying Philip.
So? Oh, David. I couldn't fire Victor's son. What is it?
Philip!
You know, there's just no fighting bad karma.
Hi, Philip.
Hello. I found this at the office. I think Dad left it for you.
Oh, thanks.
Come on in, Philip.
Thank you.
Philip, wouldn't you be more comfortable sitting on the couch?
Probably.
Philip, sit on the couch.
Thank you.
Philip?
Yes, Mom?
I've been looking over the company books tonight. And unless I do something drastic, Sandoval International is doomed. I know we're family, and I'm very fond of you. So what I'm gonna say is very difficult.
You're firing me.
No. I'm firing me.
Mick, you're kind of going against accepted business procedure here.
You can't fire yourself. You're the boss.
I know Victor left me the company, but you've been working there for years. You should be the president.
I can't. I'm useless. I'm short. I don't have an accent. My hair's thinning.
What has that got to do with it?
Don't you understand?
No.
I'm not my father.
And I'm not Lee Iacocca. Who cares? Your father was a wonderful person, and I loved him very much. But don't you understand? It's your turn now.
He'd be proud to have his son take over the company.
I can't fit in his shoes.
Philip, they make millions of kinds of shoes, and they're all different. That's because every one of us is different.
Do you really think I could do it?
No. I know you can do it.
Okay, I will. I'll turn this company around. But what are you going to do?
Well, I'm going to sit around and wait for you to make me rich. Oh. And in the meantime, I think you two could use a maid.
All right.
Nikki?
Yes?
You are a very nice person. Thanks. You're real friends.
Listen, Phil, about my musical umbrellas. I figure the best marketing strategy
would
be...
Oh, yeah, the musical umbrellas. Look, I've been evaluating the situation, and I think we're going to have to pass on them. They just don't work for me.
What? What can I tell you? It's business.
Ciao!
Well, that about does it. We can decontaminate the kitchen later. Is this for trash?
Oh, I forgot all about it. Philip brought it from the office. Box.
That's nice.
Victor was working on a lot of new projects before he... He was working on a lot of new projects.
Hello, Jay.
It's Victor.
He said, hello, Jay.
I hope I remember to get this to you. It's the night before my wedding, and, well, I've got a lot on my mind. I was thinking about your musical umbrellas. If they aren't successful, perhaps you might be interested in something like this clown. It's for a baby's room. The idea is, well, the music puts the baby to sleep, and the mother can put little messages on the tape, like, go to sleep, Billy, sweet dreams, or don't eat your rattle. It's still got a few problems in the recorder, but I'll work on it tonight. Like I said, I've got a lot on my mind, and I know I won't sleep. Buena suerte, Jay. Good luck.
What a nice man.
Yeah.
You okay? Yeah. It's just kind of a strange feeling, you know. You are very handsome. Can I keep him for a while?
Of course.
What do you say we take a little walk?
Yeah.
Victor, you idiot. You put it together backwards. Oh, no. That's right. That should work. Maybe just let it run for a while and see what happens. It's 4 o'clock in the morning. What am I doing? I am getting married. That's what I'm doing. Mickey, do you know how much I love you? I will rent Carnegie Hall, the entire New York Philharmonic, 1,000 singers, Pavarotti, and the opera will be called I Love You, Mickey. Oh, no, forget Pavarotti. I will sing it myself. Victor, unless you are in a shower, you sound like an out-of-tune bullfrog. Of course. I put a shower on a stage. I do the whole opera in my birthday suit. I love you, Mickey. I love you, Mickey. I do love you, Mickey.
Carla's finally got a man, but her lovemaking could be lethal on Cheers next. Then a child killing rocks the hill and sparks a tragic chain of events on Hill Street Blues. Spend the night with the winners. Multi-Emmy winners Cheers and Hill Street Blues next on NBC. And there are only 10 days until Kennedy, a national experience. Be there.
Thank you.
12 weeks of work and no copies?
Don't worry, I'll get it, Dave. Fast with you, clumsy oaf. Does neatness count?
What is with you anyway, huh?
It's business. I mean, no one's buying my musical toilet seats.
I think it's the recession. People just can't afford good taste. Hey, what about that quick tanning lotion you imported? The one that only takes 5 minutes.
Tan in a can?
Yeah.
That junk will never work.
Why'd you sink all your money into it?
Hey, you gotta have confidence in your product.
Mail call! Your alumni newsletters.
Oh. At least it's no bad news.
Yours had postage due.
Oh.
Maybe they'll take a musical toilet seat.
I don't believe it. Leo Gelman. They voted him graduate of the decade.
That geek? He used to eat soup with his fingers.
Maybe he couldn't afford a spoon.
Well, he's got spoons coming out of his gazingus now. He's the guy that invented that video game Death Comet.
Who would want to kill one of Santa's reindeer?
Remember, we used to make Leo laugh in the cafeteria just to watch the milk come out his nose.
Look at this. Last year, he raked in $51
million. That's nearly $1 million a week.
It's $980,769.23.
That guy makes more in a day.
He makes $139,726.02.
Mickey, how do you do that?
Just take the stem and I pull.
No, I mean the instant math.
Able to multiply and divide without thinking.
That's amazing.
Hold it. This could be the biggie. I lease Mickey to a bank.
Things called computers for that.
That's hardware, Dave. We're talking software here.
No.
Good try.
No. You're right. I gotta quit with these off-the-wall schemes. I should be more on the wall.
I'll get it, Mick.
Hi, David.
Wow.
Well?
Well, what?
Tan in the can. We tried it. We love it.
You're just trying to cheer me up because of Leo Gelman.
Who's Leo Gelman? He used to drip milk out of his nose.
That sounds cute.
This slop really works?
Hey, look at us. You should be doing cartwheels.
That's the old Jay. The new one is cautious. Restrained. Rich beyond measure! Calmly rich.
Jake, could I interject a cautionary note here?
Cautionary note. Good lawyer talk. You'll head my legal staff.
CJ, a million great ideas die every day because they're not marketed properly.
Incisive thinking. You got yourself a raise, fella.
I got an idea. Claudia works for a chain of department stores.
My boss is the VP of marketing, but she's always so busy, it's very hard to get her attention.
I got another idea.
She's on a roll.
Hey, by the way, I'll cook dinner and Claudia and Beth can model their tans.
Terrific.
I'll get champagne, caviar, cheese doodles.
Hold it. Look, I'm not even sure Mrs. Grant will come.
I knew this would all fall apart.
Claudia, could you just ask her?
Okay. All right, but look, this woman is my boss. Now, if I go out on a limb and I get her here, you have to promise me, please, you won't act like a flake.
Surely you jest. You have my personal guarantee that I will not embarrass you.
Why are you whistling like that?
I guess I'm just a little nervous.
Hey, don't be nervous. Look, this is a no-lose proposition for you. If Mrs. Grant likes tan in a can, you look good. If it bombs, It's no skin off your nose.
You're right. You're right.
Well, I can't help it. You know Jay.
I know.
Well, Mrs. Grant is a tough, no-nonsense executive. She just doesn't fool around.
I got a great one for Mrs. Grant. This chick walks into a bar with a duck in her blouse.
Would anybody mind if I sucked my thumb?
Doesn't Jay look handsome? Your suit almost fits, David.
You know, I don't mean to be critical here, good buddy, but have you thought about putting the tie inside the vest?
Not only legal counsel, but fashion advisor. You're going to need two secretaries.
Jay? Gosh, I've never seen you with your clothes on. I mean, dressed. I got a gun.
Jay, can we just go over this one more time? Okay. Now, Mrs. Grant is my...
I know. I got the book on her. Is Republican, left-handed, favorite drink, margarita, charities, humane society, and supports the police athletically.
Pretty good, huh?
How did you remember all that?
It's all on your cup.
You wrote on my new shirt with a pen?
Me? Write on your shirt? Never. I typed it.
Oh. All right. I'll get the wine.
You get the wine. Mrs. Grant, welcome.
Claudia, dear, kiss. And do call me Louise.
Louise, this is Jay Bostwick.
Hi, I hear you're an athletic supporter.
This is David Tucker.
Nice to meet you.
How do you do?
How are you?
Beth Sorensen.
Hello.
Louise, I understand we share an interest in the Humane Society, antique furniture, and no starch.
This is Mickey McKenzie. This is David and Jay's housekeeper.
Pleased to meet you, ma'am.
How charming. Yes, she used to work at Tara.
Louise?
Thank you.
Louise, would you like a drink?
Yes, I would love one. How nice. I don't suppose you would happen to have a...
Margarita, ma'am?
Oh, well, thank you, Mickey. I don't suppose I could get a...
Strawberry?
Oh, that is wonderful. Now, you wouldn't possibly have a...
Wedge of lime?
That's amazing. How did you know?
Why, this is Mr. Boswick's favorite drink.
As if I'd come from a long line of left-handed Republican margarita drinkers.
Have a housekeeper like that. But do tell me about this new product that Claudia's raving about.
Well, you're looking at it.
We were white as ghosts yesterday.
Uh-huh.
Just uh-huh. These are pretty terrific tans.
They look like beef jerky in dresses.
Children, I did not get to be a top executive just by stepping over some people and gutting a few on the way to the top. I need some proof.
You want proof? You got proof. Mickey, will you come out here for a moment, please?
How may I be of service, Mr. Boswick, sir?
Mickey, I would like you to put this on, please.
Yes, Mr. Boswick, I'll put this on, and then I'll toss the salad.
That's adorable. How much are you making?
Lots. I have three different kinds of lettuce.
Well, within minutes, she'll be a bronzed goddess.
If you're right, young man, you are about to become rich.
How rich?
Well, let's say 20 million cans at $7.50 a can with a 15% royalty, roughly in the neighborhood of...
$22,500,000. $22 million? You can get a Rolls Royce for every day in the week.
Take that, Leo Gelman!
Oh, do you know Leo? I just had lunch with him last week. He's a very strange man. He got to laughing so hard his martini came right out his nose. I'm ready. So soon? Stupendous. Jay, welcome to our little family. Kiss, kiss.
Hug, hug.
Well, I've got better aim. Congratulations.
You make a great model, Nick.
Glad I could help, Miss Beth.
You know, I've got to try this tan in a can.
Allow me, partner.
Wait till you see the reactions you get. When my kindergarten class saw me, they made up a song about it. You're so brown, you're so brown, you're so brown, you're so brown.
Catchy.
Well, why don't we all sit down, huh? Dinner should be ready.
Great. Suddenly I'm famished.
Louise, I guarantee you, in the time that it takes for this sand to run out, you will have a gorgeous tan.
I can hardly wait. I can't get over the change in Mickey's color. Dinner.
Blue. Stew. Fish. Bluefish stew. I'll check.
Blue.
Maybe you're not blue. Let's not jump to conclusions. Jay, the girl's blue. Maybe it's just a bad case of varicose veins.
Jay, why did I turn blue and Claudia Beth didn't?
Who cares? Now what?
I don't know.
Some legal advisor. You can kiss your raise goodbye, fella.
Come on, Jay, get back in the ball game here. What if Louise sees Mickey?
I'll tell her I'm cold.
Would that work?
Jay, you've got to go out there and tell her.
Maybe it's just a fluke. Maybe it will turn to tan.
Yeah, maybe the Statue of Liberty will get pregnant.
Maybe. You never know who she'll meet in that harbor.
Listen, we can't wait in here forever. Mrs. Grant is going to get suspicious.
Relax. Claudia can handle it. She's good under pressure.
I tell you, we got to pull out all the stops on this tan in a can. I want newspaper and magazine ads. Get me a young Brooke Shields. Right. We'll do television commercials. Right. Now, don't buck me on this, Marv. Just do as I say. How's my color doing?
I can see a change already.
Good.
Wine, anyone?
Oh, wonderful.
Dave, the wine?
Huh?
Friday.
My day to pour.
Oh, that's good. What is it?
Blue Nun.
Guys, dinner's ready. Can you help me?
You bet, sure.
You're such gentlemen.
I encourage good manners in my kindergarten class. In fact, we have a song about it. Manners are good, manners are good, manners are good, manners are good.
They're creative little buggers.
I wrote it.
You know, the suspense is killing me. I have got to go to the powder room and look at my tan.
Oh, the mirror's broken. You can't go in there for 7 years.
Time to strap on the old feed bag.
Oh, this does look wonderful.
Mickey is a marvel, a wonderful cook,
a wonderful housekeeper. Well, I bet I could see myself in this place.
Have seconds.
We haven't had first.
Well, here we have seconds first, then first second. That way you don't get so full.
Could you guys give me a hand? I forgot the rolls.
Huh?
Let's get our buns in the kitchen.
Right. Oh, doesn't Mickey serve?
She cooks.
She cleans.
She calculates, but she doesn't serve food.
It's a religious thing.
How's it going? I'd rather have a root canal.
I know it doesn't look good.
Well put.
But if we can just buy some time, maybe we can salvage this deal.
Yeah, that's what John DeLorean said.
I mean, Lawrence was a wonderful hairdresser, but his voice was unbelievable. I mean, he could have been another Pavarotti. Unfortunately, though, one day when he was singing an aria for a customer, he choked on a hairball and died.
Well.
You know, in the last presidential election, my uncle voted for Cesar Romero.
Excuse me.
But can I help you in here?
No.
Please.
No, everything's under control.
No, there must be something I can do.
Ooh, green beans.
Need salt.
Salt. Let me see. If I were the old salt, where would I be?
In the Navy.
Oh, thank you, Mickey.
Wait. Did I see what I think I just saw?
Someone put a bay leaf in with green beans.
It's gonna be okay. It's gonna be okay. It's gonna be okay.
Well, now the beans are perfection. Come on, let's all eat before it gets cold.
Doesn't this look good? Oh, I'll just get the others out of the kitchen.
Oh, couldn't you just call them?
That would be rude.
So, here we are again.
Lucky me.
Did I tell you there was a little boy in my class who bites?
No, but I'm sure you will.
Mickey?
Oh, hi, Mrs. Grant. I'm just going to take a bath.
I wish I could take a cab.
Hey, did you hear one about the lady who walked into a bar with a duck in her blouse? Do you want to hear it again?
Jay, you're going to go in there and you're going to tell her now.
I can't.
Jay, you can't let her buy that stuff. It doesn't work.
Well, then we'll sell it to the Pentagon. They'll buy anything that doesn't work.
Jay, you've got a vivid imagination, right, buddy?
I like to think so.
Okay, picture this with me, all right? You're living in the south of France, driving along in your Rolls, on the way to take a lunch with Leo Gelman.
Sounds good.
Now, picture this. You're wearing denim, making license plates, sharing a 4x4 cell with a 6'8" axe murderer named Mongo. And he wants you to wear sundresses.
Can you hold that thought, Dave? I gotta talk to Mrs. Grant.
Yeah.
Then the duck said, sure, but what am I gonna do with these two footballs?
Louise, I can't sell you tan in a can. The deal's off.
I beg your pardon.
I'm so unhappy.
I'm sorry I brought you here on such a wild goose chase, but, well, I'm afraid his mind is really made up.
You want more money. All right, sign now, and I'll give you a bonus of $5 million.
Five?
Mrs. Grant, more money won't change his mind.
Oh, hardball, huh? All right, foreign rights, $8 million.
Jay can't sell you tan in a can because Mickey's blue.
Who cares if your maid is depressed? talking big bucks here. I'm not leaving till the deal is closed. Now, everybody, sit down. We are going to eat. I'll play mother. Who wants mashed potatoes?
I'm blue.
It's a nice shade of blue.
It's more like aquamarine.
Makes your teeth look whiter. And sharper.
I'm sorry I brought you in on such a fiasco. I will have my desk cleaned out tomorrow and I'll...
Claudia, honey, this isn't your fault.
He's right, Claudia. Things like this happen in business. It's not the end of the world. I don't blame you.
You mean you're not mad? You know, Lou, you're some hell of a broad. We were really worried you'd be really steamed. Hey, I'd like to propose a toast. Here's to you, Louise.
No, Jay. Here's to you. Jay, can I come in?
Sure. How you doing?
I look like a giant Smurf.
You know, if I'd sold just one can of 10 in the can to every single American, I would have made about...
$1,650,000,000.
Wait a minute. How do you do that with the numbers?
It's easy. Anybody can.
Really?
Yeah.
Great. We open up a chain of famous multiplier schools.
Just picture in your mind an adding machine and a finger.
Yeah?
Your finger punches in 220 million Americans.
Yeah?
Now it punches 750.
Huh?
Now you punch the multiply key.
How do you get the answer so fast?
You just go...
Hey, great news. Mrs. Grant called. She's fading.
Oh, great.
But now Bess had a reaction to tan in a can.
Well, don't worry. She won't be blue for long.
That's not the problem.
Up on Cheers, but will the coach strike out with his new baseball team? And on Hill Street Blues, if Frank becomes the new chief, will the politics destroy him? And Sunday, Paul Newman is the cop, caught between a code of silence and a code of law. In Fort Apache, the Bronx, Sunday on NBC. Be there.